Hi, everyone, and thanks for tuning into Weather on the Web. I'm 4029 meteorologist Brad Carl. Well, we've had very little to complain about so far for this weekend. Ample sunshine, warm temperatures, and what otherwise could be a very active time of year since we're in the middle of severe weather season, but it just hasn't been the case for the last several days, and we're not about to change things up, at least not just yet. Take a look at your satellite and radar. You'll notice a lot of sunshine out there for this afternoon and on to this evening. We'll get things pretty clear overnight. Not really going to see anything really impact us a whole lot since most of the weather making is being done to our north and well off to our west. So we'll stay quiet for tonight and also as we move on into your Sunday. So for tonight, you can go ahead and expect things to stay very nice and comfortable for this evening. We already have temperatures still in the upper 70s and low 80s through about your 7 o'clock hour, and we'll keep things in the 60s through most of the rest of this evening before falling down into the 50s early on for your Sunday morning. Over the next several days, the warm weather will be sticking around as well. Highs close to 80 degrees, and the best part of all, we don't have a whole lot of humidity to deal with just yet. That'll kick in later, though. We'll also see a chance, along with that humidity, for more storms to fire up, especially toward the tail end of our extended forecast. I'll break that down for you in just a moment. For tonight, though, temperatures in the mid-50s, comfortable, mostly clear, a light breeze. If you have afternoon, evening plans, you'll be in very good shape. Won't have to worry about any kind of problems from Mother Nature getting on in your way. As far as your hour-by-hour forecast is concerned, yeah, a few high clouds will be possible late tonight into early tomorrow morning, but no showers, no rain, just a beautiful stretch of weather as you push on through your Sunday. Obviously, nice and dry. Once again, a few more high clouds possible, but other than that, it'll be a nice, beautiful, sunny day once again. Really a nice encore performance compared to the beautiful weather we had for your Saturday. But as we push on to the start of this next week, we are going to notice a bit of a pattern change. We'll kind of zoom things out here. We're going to have a low pressure center set up just off to our west in parts of central Kansas, and that's going to put us in a southwesterly flow. What does that mean in layman's terms? Well, it means we're going to be pulling off a lot more of this air off of parts of central Texas, parts of Mexico, and the Gulf of Mexico, and that's going to have us feeling a lot more humid, especially as we get on to about midweek and pushing on a little closer into next weekend, and it'll also give us a chance for some additional showers and thunderstorms as well. So as we look ahead for the extended forecast, the good news is that for the weekend, things are looking just fine. High of 80 degrees for you on your Sunday in northwest Arkansas, and we'll keep those temperatures right around the 80 degree mark for the next several days. Slight chance of showers moves in for your Tuesday, but much better opportunity for more widespread showers and storms kicks in Wednesday and lingers on through the rest of the work week and even pushes on into next weekend. If you are planning on going to the Bentonville Film Festival, I would certainly want to watch the forecast as that will be going on Tuesday through Saturday. Of course, that's when all the showers and storms arrive, wouldn't you know it. Highs will remain in the mid-70s. For the River Valley, you'll be looking at highs for your Sunday right around the mid-80s, so nice and balmy, no humidity to worry about yet. That humidity will start kicking on in into midweek, just right in line with those additional chances for showers and storms. We'll see highs drop down into the upper 70s and low 80s for Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. And some of those storms could end up being a bit on the strong side, so that's something we'll keep an eye on as we get a little bit closer. So, in a nutshell, enjoy our beautiful, dry, and non-humid weather for the next couple days before we get back to a more typical spring-like pattern into the late part of this next week. Have a great rest of your Saturday, everyone.